No, it's not easy being married. We haven't got much of a sex life nowadays. In fact, we just lie in bed and fart at each other. Think about it. I know. We were in bed all last Sunday. I'll bet I'm not on my own, eh? I'll bet there's some blanket lifters out there. And we were in bed all last Sunday afternoon. We were doing it plumber's position. And they call it the plumber because you stop in all day and nobody comes. And the trouble is with we've all met a fella like this, Des. You know, he's going through the male menopause and he's dyeing his hair, jogging. He's going to the gym 3 days a week. And he's in the butcher's shop, he's bought his meat, and he's a lovely young girl serving him. And he says to her, I bet you can't guess how old I am. She said, you're about 39. He said, I'm 56. I look after myself, I go jogging. Well, he goes out and he stood at the bus stop. And this old lady come and stood next to him. She said, do you know, I don't know who you are, but I'm so excited. I'm 70 today, she said, and when I get back to sheltered accommodation, they're doing a party for me. I'm so excited. He said, very nice, love. Have a nice birthday. He said, I bet you can't guess how old I am. She said, well, if you let me put my hand down the front of your pants, I'll tell you to the year. He said, go on then. So she puts her hand down and she's fumbling about. About 5 minutes later, she pulled her hand out. She said, you're 56. He says, my God, how did you guess that? She said, I was stood behind you in the butcher's. She said, it's not bad, is it? And no, you know, when I met my wife, she was a secretary, you know, and then she married me, and now she's a treasurer. And she budgets well, though. We do without lots of things that I don't need, you know.
How's your gran? You usually tell me interesting things about your grandmother.
Oh, my grandmother. She was a tough old lady, my grandma. She was one of the women who got the vote, you know, with Emily Plankhurst. And hey, she was a suffering get, my grandma. She was one of the... But she had to be strong, because my granddad was dual alley, you know, and as we say in Yorkshire, he was limp under the cap. And he was a nice man, my granddad. He died in his sleep at a Max Bygraves concert, you know. And just before he died, they went to the Showcase Cinema in Yorkshire. They were queuing up, they were going in like that. And he saw a bundle of £50 notes on the floor. So he said to my grandma, ooh, pick that money up, pick it up, pick it up. So she picks it up, this big one of 50s. She said, what shall I do with it? He said, keep it safe, when we come out, stick it down your knickers, whatever. So she bins it. And they're coming out. He said to her, come on then, give us that money. She went, oh, it's gone. He said, how do you mean it's gone? She said, it must have been that fella that was sat next to me. He said, what did you let him do that for? She said, well, I didn't know he were a thief. Did I?
You've always got these wonderful jokes. I mean, I've been around. But you've always got these jokes, which are, you know...
I like gags. People don't tell gags anymore, do
they? No. Good jokes like that are great.
I mean, there's a fella coming through the checkout at Tesco's and he's got one potato.
There's Tesco people here. Tesco's in.
Are they in? Oh, right. Anyway, this fella's going through Sainsbury's checkout and he's got one potato, one banana, one tomato, one apple, one orange, a small tea cake, a small tin of beans and a small tin of peas. And the girl's pulling through, she goes, beep, beep. She said, I bet you live on your own, don't you? He said, that's very observant, love. Is that because I'm buying small quantities? She said, no, it's because you're an ugly pig. She said, yeah. There you go. Wonderful. It's a ripper, isn't it, I know.
You want to tell the tattoo, Joe? I know we probably won't be able to run this one, but tell them the... Any jokes you like.
So this, hey, lovely crowd. Can I be honest? I'm getting on my own nerves a bit now. This young lady, she goes in the tattoo parlour and she says to the fella, "Now, I'm getting married next Saturday," she said, "and I want to surprise my husband-to-be," she said. "He's really into tattoos, and I just want you to tattoo a little butterfly on each cheek and my bottom as a surprise." He said, "Butterflies? I wouldn't even attempt it, my love," he said. "They're the most difficult thing to tattoo," he said. "You can't cover them up if you make a mistake." He said, "I'll do your bees." He said, "I'm world famous for my bees, by the way. I'm the world leader, but I won't do your butterflies." She said, "Well, I want..." He said, "I'll do your bees, but..." She said, "All right, then, I'll have two bees." So he tattoos on each cheek of a bottom. Anyway, on the wedding night, I'll stand up for this. She comes out of the bathroom like that, and she went to her husband, "What do you think of this, then?" He said, "Who the hell's Bob?" He said... I don't know.
I tell you what, I wasn't aware of. You got any more before we get on?
The thing is, yeah, I've got hundreds of them, and I just can't think of them. And when I met my wife, she was a secretary, and I told you that, didn't you? Well, you see, I've started shopping at these second shops, you know, now. Not second hand, but you know the garments are not quite perfect, right? Well, hey, I bought a designer jacket last week, £20. The only thing I can find wrong with this jacket, right, one of the sleeves is a bit shorter than the other two. Now... So, anyway... So this fella picks the phone up and this voice went, "Hello, is that 777-7777? He said, "Yeah." He said, "Would you ring 999 and tell them I've got my finger stuck in 7?